Remember the bully teacher who called his students fat, who told them things about their own bodies that he knew more than they did, dropped the F-bomb, was really rude, talked about his own mom and daddy. Well, we got more information about that guy. Let me take you back to the video. Here it is.
Society is trying to make you as soft as possible so that everybody feels good about themselves. Like, if you're fat, whose fault is that? Yours. And I'll tell you that straight up. That's because of the things you put in your mouth. That ain't nobody forced it down your throat. But everybody wants to be body positive. Let's celebrate fat people. Why? They just f***ing die because they're fat. Yeah, y'all laugh. This is the truth. Again, don't care. You're fat.
It can be genetic.
That's a excuse. It can be genetic. Yeah. Guess what? My entire family's fat. I'm not. I'm one of the most in shape people around you. I do marathons. All my parents are fat. My parents are fat, and so is my brother. That's not genetics. Excuse. That's okay. That's fine. That's the mindset y'all have. Let's find an excuse. It's somebody else's fault. It's always somebody else's fault. I couldn't get to class, coach. Whatever. It's somebody else's fault. It's not your fault. Take responsibility for yourself. Okay? No one cares, especially when you come to my class. And y'all probably should understand that by now. We're almost 20 weeks into school. Some of y'all still don't understand how it operates. Some of y'all still don't understand if you just turn your work in, you'll pass this class. Okay? The people who do, you're like, yeah, it's easy. I don't see how you're failing. But I mean, there's over 50% of this class has failed. That's all it is. And that frustrates me as a person because I just feel like I'm wasting my time talking to a bunch of idiots who don't give a. That's frustrating as a teacher. I wish I could be in my position. They haven't got heads up now because Coach Diffie's throwing the F-bomb out everywhere.
Oh, sir, you are going to be responsible. Yes, you are going to be responsible today. So you call your students idiots. You drop the F-bomb, in other words, derogatory terminology. You're unprofessional. You speak down to them rather than speaking up. Over 50% of your class is failing because you are. Your pedagogy is lacking because you cannot inspire education. You see, education is not about what you teach. Education is about what you connect. And if you do not have the ability to connect to those in front of you, you are the wrong educator to be in front of them. That's how this works. Now, after airing our initial reporting, more parents and others have come out saying this guy is bad on that video, but he's actually worse in other scenarios. We have the information. Parents at the school are now speaking up about what they call an obvious pattern bullying. Here's more info.
You're wasting your time, more importantly. It's not really mine. But I do appreciate those people. But you others clowns, dude, y'all go f*** yourselves, honestly. You're just wasting my time. You're wasting your time, more importantly. It's not really mine.
Mike Diffie is his name. Let's put up the picture full mask here. So Mr. Diffie is a Shreveport teacher. He's just keeping it real, right? That's what he's doing. This is a lecture he's giving. He's just keeping it real. Here is what parents posted on Facebook in the aftermath of the initial video. We have it right here. The Facebook user Brittana Beard wrote, and I quote, "My son said this is Coach Diffie, and he has always talked to them like that. I had no clue." This person also wrote, and I quote, "I also found out he is the teacher that slammed my son into the wall. My son is telling me a lot now that he has graduated." A parent of the high school contacted Indisputable. He verified for us his son is a current student, but requested anonymity for fear of retaliation against his son because his son is a current student. He alleges that Mr. Duffy used his position as coach and teacher to intimidate and harass players and students he dislikes, encouraging students to join in his bullying. Here's a quote from that parent. "They're being intimidated and bullied by other students These children are being manipulated by this teacher. Certain people will defend him and say they've heard worse, but it's wrong. The children are begging their parents not to identify them for fear this man or students he encourages will bully them. Mr. Diffie, you can't bully me. I'm a grown ass man. You walk around bullying children. Yeah, man. That's what they say. That's what I saw in the video. You're a tough guy. Nobody should talk to anybody else's children that way. Now, there are some people who will support you and say, well, he's just telling it like it is. The idea is to be effective, not offensive. Just because someone is offensive, it does not mean they are effective. And that's the reason we have professional conduct rules inside of school systems, because we have to be effective. We cannot destroy the notion of example to be offensive to students, to children, because we disagree with their behavior. They are immature children. They are growing into maturity. He's talking to his class as if they are at the bar together. There's more. He alleges Mr. Duffy manipulates him. We already got that. The parent said his son was berated and vulgarity shouted at him on the field, and he was further humiliated in the classroom by Mr. Diffie himself. Marquell Sennett, Director of Communications and Marketing, Caddo Parish Public Schools, reached back out to Indisputable. Here's an exact quote. Caddo Parish Public Schools takes all concerns that are expressed by students and parents seriously. When the initial video surfaced on Facebook, district staff took immediate action and launched an investigation. We will continue working with parents to ensure that every student has a safe learning environment and will respond to all complaints that are brought to our attention. State law prohibits us from commenting further on personnel matters. The district placed Mr. Diffie on administrative leave last week. Here is the school superintendent. This is Dr. Lamar Gorey. Buck stops with you, sir. We expect leadership on this and leadership quickly. As it relates to the children who are under the leadership of this particular teacher, please understand the negatives that he reinforces. It is because of his own immaturity. And if there are individuals who are young and feel as if he's the cool kid in the class, just remember, he's a grown man acting like a child. There's nothing cool about that whatsoever. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
So many, Dr. Richey. I've never seen a teacher, a coach motivate less. You remember in the National Football League, Tom Coughlin, they said he was bullying the Giants players because he'd fine them. He'd say, if you're not 5 minutes early, then you're late. Okay, they said that was bullying. You're right, these are children, young minds. And real quick, Dr. Richey, pedagogy, I had to look it up. Mr. Diffie, Coach Diffie would too. The art, science, or profession of teaching, pedagogy. Right. He taught us all something.
That's right. I really do hope that the institution does the right thing and provides clear leadership and becomes an advocate for students and not Mr. Diffie.